Welcome to this week's video. This week's video, I'm going to be showing you how to set the charge delay on a BMW i3. This will also apply to the i8, which has a similar silly system. And the reason I have to show you this is because it's not as straightforward as you think. I'm also going to tell you some interesting little features about the i3 that you might not already know. Quick little thing before I show you how to set the charge delay on the BMW i3, if you could go down below and click the subscribe button, and also if you're already a subscriber, if you click that notification bell, you'll be notified every time I make a new video. I make videos about electric cars, features on electric cars, and there's a whole host of BMW i3 videos on my channel. Now, I've done a video about BMW Easter eggs, which if you haven't seen, it shows you some hidden features on a BMW i3. That you might not know, and secret hidden menus, where certain pull switches are and how to do certain things. Someone in the comments mentioned something that I missed about the BMW iDrive sat-nav, which is you can zoom in and zoom out by pinching the top touch control button on here. Now, the reason I'm going to have to show you this is BMW weirdly haven't made setting a charge delay on your BMW very easily. You can't do it by the app unless you have a BMW charger, which most people don't have in the UK. And if you are thinking of getting a charger, by the way, there's a video at the top right I made about a whole host of different chargers you can buy. Just boot up the iDrive, easiest thing ever. Select your profile, very easy. Hit the menu button, get into the main menu, and then we need to scroll over to the My Vehicle Settings. When we're in the My Vehicle Settings, we need to scroll down to Plan Charging Climate Control. And if you've not done this before, this is where you're going to get really confused. You've got Charge Immediately and Charge by Departure Time. Now, you're going to click Charge for Departure Time. Now, if this doesn't let you select Charge Departure Time, if that is greyed out, which it will be if you've never been in the setting before and the BMW is new to you, you need to scroll all the way down to Next Departure and set a departure time. You need to set a day and a departure time. Now, this doesn't have to be a generic, real one. This doesn't have to be a real day that you're departing. It can be a fake departure time. So set a fake departure time, go back, and then charge departure time for departure time will now no longer be grayed out. And we can click that, and then we can go down to Tariff Time Slot. And that is where we're going to go into that, and it says charge with off-peak tariff. Obviously, that's what we select. And we select the hours that you want to charge under this off-peak tariff. Now, if you're an Octopus Go customer like me, you're going to pick between 12:30 and 4:30. And this gives you 5p electric with Octopus, and that is what I'm currently using. If you want a link to Octopus, to join Octopus Energy in the UK, there's a link down below in the description. You'll get £50 for switching to Octopus Energy, and so will I, which is great for both of us. They are probably one of the best energy companies I've ever been with. Great customer service. When you do need them, they do answer. And that is the test of a company, is if they have customer service staff that actually do answer your inquiries. Back to the BMW now. So we've got the tariff at 12:30. We go back from that, that's fine, and it's set. We can now go out, plug the car in, and you'll get an indication on the car that the charge is set for those 12:30 to 4:30 tariff, which I've set it for, and the light will flash instead of, say, solid when you plug it in. Now, another little hidden thing that people didn't know about, this departure time, yes, it's stupid that you have to set it from BMW and they should just allow you to pick an off-peak tariff, but there is a feature of that departure time that can be useful, and that is if you are setting a real departure time, a real day that you're leaving, so let's just say tomorrow at 8:49 on Thursday and Saturday, I am going to leave the house for my journey where I'm going. Now, if I've preset that and the car is plugged in, the battery will preheat. Yes, you heard me correctly. If the departure time is set and the car is fully charged and prepped and ready to go, the car will preheat itself. Now, when I say preheat, no, I don't mean the cabin gets nice warm. I mean the battery will preheat the battery pack, so the battery is in the most optimal temperature for driving, which means you'll get a little bit more range, a little bit more charge out of your battery, which is a great thing. And now, while we're in this setting, you can also set precondition for departure time. So that uses that departure time to not only precondition the battery, but also precondition the cabin. So it will preheat the cabin. Now this is very useful if you want to melt a bit of snow and ice off the windscreens, and also in the summer to cool down the cabin if it's a very, very hot day. So they are two extra additional features that you can use under that departure time. Don't go trying to set any sort of charge delays on the BMW app, it won't work. You can preheat your cabin on the BMW app. If you go on the BMW app, you can click climatize now and that will pre-climatize your cabin. There's pretty much no reason I can think why BMW have made it this way. It just is what it is. So yeah, sorry about that. If you've enjoyed watching this week's video, thanks very much. Please give it a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, go on, please click subscribe. And if you want to support my channel in another way, go and check out the Patreon page. If you don't know what it's about, just have a look at the Patreon page and you'll see a link for that down below. Thanks very much. I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.